Now, good morning, greetings, namaste, very warm welcome to all of you to this webinar on behalf of the High Commission of Canada and India Rights Network. A special word of welcome to our journalist friends from Bhutan, Nepal, and neighboring countries. Deputy High Commissioner of Canada to India, Deirdre Kent, Excellencies, friends from media and other related fields, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Manish Chand. I'm founder, CEO, and editor-in-chief of India Rights Network and India and the World magazine. Our company, DJII Media, is involved in five verticals: media, publishing, research, consultancy, and advocacy. It's our enormous pleasure and honor to partner with the High Commission of Canada in this very important debate on the role of the media in promoting greater awareness of environment-related issues. Ladies and gentlemen, we are extremely fortunate to have such a distinguished panel and audience to debate these complex issues today. The theme of today's webinar, COVID-19 and Beyond, Environment in the Media, is prescient and timely. The theme has two interlinked parts. One is the impact of COVID-19 on the environment, and the second part seeks to scrutinize how environmental issues have been reported and analyzed in the media. Ladies and gentlemen, we are meeting at a time when the weather is changing, and the changing weather is on everyone's mind, especially in Delhi, from where this webinar is being conducted. After some bitterly cold days in December and January, the last few days in February have a summer-like feel, with temperatures soaring above 30 degrees Celsius, something unheard of in this part of the world at this time of the year. In Delhi and most of North India, when there was a time when winter used to stretch from September to March end, now winter has shrunk to barely 6 weeks. It is not, however, a nostalgia for long Delhi winter or pristine blue skies, which we saw during the days of the lockdown, that has brought all of us here together for this virtual conference. We have gathered to discuss the twin dangers of climate change and global warming that poses an existential threat to the entire humanity. The recent Uttarakhand floods of 2021 in Nanda Devi National Park, a UNESCO World Heritage Site, the California wildfires of 2020, Typhoon Ulysses, which affected Philippines and Vietnam, and the dance of destruction unleashed by Cyclone Amphan in West Bengal, Odisha, and Bangladesh in May 2020, all these climate-linked disasters brought out vividly the apocalypse that awaits us if we don't act purposely and urgently. Against this broader backdrop of a looming climate emergency and a spate of climate-linked disasters, the discussion today will focus on the role of the media in analyzing and reporting the existential dangers posed by climate change. We will be debating whether the media is doing enough and what more can be done to raise awareness about environment-related issues. In this regard, let me underline that 2021 is a defining year for global climate negotiations, which have acquired a new resonance with the return of the United States to the Paris Accord. In April 2021, US President Joe Biden will be hosting a landmark Earth Day summit that will bring all major emitters, along with other countries, to raise their commitment to curb greenhouse gas emissions. This will be followed by major multilateral summits, which will focus on climate change, including the G7 summit in U.K., to which India has also been invited, and the COP26, which will be held in Glasgow in November. This online conference focused on environment and climate change is therefore timely, and I would urge all speakers and audience to focus on suggestions and recommendations for shaping an action-oriented agenda for combating global warming. The scale of the climate challenge is such that no nation can afford the luxury of living in splendid isolation. In this journey, we sail and sing together. The spirit of global solidarity and caring for the environment is deeply embedded in the Indian ethos of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, the world is one family. As far as climate change and environment is concerned, India and Canada, the two G20 economies and major democracies, have a striking convergence of perspective. Sustainable development and green development is the mantra of the time. There is enough in the world for everyone's need, but not for everyone's greed, as Mahatma Gandhi said famously. At this stage, let me outline some housekeeping rules of engagement. To the audience, you can type in your questions, comments on Q&A box in the course of the webinar or chat box. Please maintain decorum, in terms of what you comment on. Anybody indulging in improper comments may be barred from the rest of the webinar. Social media, we encourage you to tweet about the webinar. Please tag Canada in India and India writes